Have you ever wondered if your supposedly secure HTTPS connection could be secretly downgraded to an insecure HTTP1, leaving your sensitive data exposed? That's exactly what we're exploring in this video. Welcome back, Cyber Guardians. Today we're diving into a fascinating yet alarming topic in the world of cybersecurity, SSL stripping. Buckle up, because we're about to uncover the hidden vulnerabilities in what many consider to be secure web browsing. Before we begin, I want to emphasize that the techniques we're discussing today are for educational purposes only. Using these methods without explicit permission is not just unethical, it's illegal. Our goal is to understand these attacks so we can better defend against them, not to cause harm. With that said, let's dive in. First, let's set the stage. We're going to demonstrate an SSL stripping attack, which is a type of man-in-the-middle attack that downgrades a secure HTTPS connection to an unsecure HTTP1. This allows an attacker to potentially intercept and manipulate data that the user thinks is being sent securely. Let's start by setting up our attack environment. We'll be using Kali Linux, a distribution designed for penetration testing and ethical hacking. First, we need to gain root privileges. Open your terminal and type sudo su. This elevates our permissions, allowing us to install and run the tools we need. Next, let's make sure our system is up to date. Run apt-update to refresh our package lists. This ensures we're working with the latest versions of our tools. For this demonstration, we need two key tools, SSLstrip and Dsniff. SSLstrip is what we'll use to perform the actual SSL stripping attack, while Dsniff contains tools for network auditing and penetration testing, including ARP spoof, which we'll use for our initial man-in-the-middle attack. Let's install SSLstrip first. Type apt install SSLstrip and press enter. Now let's install Dsniff with apt install Dsniff. If prompted, type E to confirm the installation. With our tools installed, we're ready to begin the attack. But first, we need some crucial information: the IP address of our router, the IP address of our target machine, and the network interface we're operating on. To find our router's IP address, we'll use the command route n. This displays the routing table, and the IP address listed under gateway is typically your router's IP. Now for our target machine's IP, we'll use nmap, a powerful network scanning tool. Run the command nmap ss o router IP 24, replacing router IP with the address you just found. This scans your local network and lists all connected devices. Look for the entry that shows a Windows operating system. That's our target for this demonstration. Lastly, we need to know our network interface. Run ifconfig to see all network interfaces. Look for WLAN 0 if you're on Wi-Fi, or ETS 0 for a wired connection. Note the interface name and your Kali machine's IP address while you're here. Now that we have all this information, let's start our MITM attack using ARP spoof. Open a new terminal window, gain root privileges again, and run this command. ARP spoof I network interface T target IP, router IP. This command tells the target machine that our Kali machine is the router. We're not done yet. Copy this command, open a new terminal, and paste. But swap the target IP and router IP. This fools the router into thinking our Kali machine is the target. Run both these commands simultaneously in separate terminal windows. With these commands running, we've successfully positioned ourselves between the target and the router. But we're not done yet. We need to ensure that traffic can still flow through our machine. Run this command. Echo 1 proxysnet IPv4 IP underscore forward. This allows our Kali machine to pass network traffic from the router to the target machine without interruption. Next, we need to configure our IP tables to redirect traffic. Run this command. IP tables TNAT, A, pre-routing, PTCP, D port 80, J redirect, to port 8080. This redirects all traffic destined for port 80 HTTP to port 8080, where our SSL strip will be listening. Finally, we're ready to run SSLstrip. Clear your terminal and type SSLstrip L8080. and there we have it. We've successfully set up an SSL stripping attack. In theory, this would allow us to intercept and potentially manipulate data that the user thinks is being sent securely over HTTPS. However, it's crucial to note that this attack isn't as effective in 2024 as it was when first introduced. Many websites now use HTTP, Strict Transport Security, HSTS, which forces browsers to use HTTPS connections. Modern browsers also have built-in protections against these types of attacks. To successfully downgrade a website, you'd need to use an outdated browser that doesn't support HSTS, like older versions of Internet Explorer. The cybersecurity landscape is constantly evolving, with new protections being developed all the time. Now, let's talk about how to protect yourself and your users from SSL stripping attacks. Here are some key strategies. First and foremost, always use HTTPS. As a website owner, implement HTTPS across your entire site, not just on login pages. Use HSTS headers to force browsers to always use HTTPS connections to your site. For users, be cautious when browsing, especially on public Wi-Fi networks. Look for the padlock icon in your browser's address bar, which indicates a secure HTTPS connection. If you see a warning about an insecure connection, don't ignore it, it could be a sign of an SSL stripping attack. Keep your software up to date. This includes your operating system, web browsers, and any security software you use. Updates often include important security patches that can protect against the latest threats. Consider using a virtual private network, VPN, especially when on public Wi-Fi. A VPN encrypts all your internet traffic, providing an extra layer of security. For network administrators, implement security measures like HTTPS inspection and SSL TLS monitoring. These can help detect and prevent SSL stripping attacks on your network. Educate your users about the importance of secure connections. Teach them to be wary of entering sensitive information on websites without HTTPS, and to pay attention to security warnings from their browsers. Finally, consider using browser extensions that force HTTPS connections whenever possible. While not foolproof, these can provide an extra layer of protection against downgrade attacks. Remember, cybersecurity is an ongoing process. Attackers are constantly developing new techniques, so it's crucial to stay informed and regularly update your security practices. In conclusion, while SSL stripping attacks may not be as effective as they once were, understanding them helps us appreciate the importance of secure connections and the ongoing arms race between attackers and defenders in the cybersecurity world. As always, use this knowledge responsibly. Our goal as ethical hackers isn't to cause harm, but to make the digital world a safer place for everyone. Stay curious, stay ethical, and keep learning. Until next time, this is Tech Sky, signing off.
One, two, three, make it run, body to power body, hotter than ice, one,